Frosty, Heidi, and Frank
are back.
Right here!
Right here!
Right now!
Right now!
On Southern California's rock station, 95.5 KLOS.
Frosty, Heidi, and Frank show, almost 9:30 here on a Monday. It's like Christmas. Not Motley Crue, the band. This is like from Metallica, the band. It's a blackened whiskey, just released. Blackened American Whiskey, limited edition batch 100 whiskey and vinyl box set.
Woo!
Look at this thing. Especially the plastic on eBay. Like a house payment.
Seriously.
Batch 100 will only be available as part of the box set. To purchase, you can go to blackenedwhiskey.com. We can tear off the wrapping paper here. Two 12-inch vinyl picture discs of the Metallica Batch 100 playlist. And then Blackened Batch 100. Look at this.
Frank, look at this. Wow, yeah.
That is pretty awesome. So picture vinyls.
Oh, smell that.
With the playlist on it.
Oh, smell it. Mm-hmm. That smells like Christmas morning.
The inside has what?
Blackened, live, Creeping Death, live.
In the center of the bottle of whiskey itself, which is great. We've had on the show many, many times.
Oh, this is
the
sweet.
The playlist includes Blackened Live, Creeping Death Live, The Unforgiven Live, Disposable Heroes, Fade to Black, Spit Out the Bone, Whiplash, Nothing Else Matters, Live Acoustic. So for Metallica fans, this is the ultimate in gifts.
Killer.
Look at that, Eric. See the vinyl?
That's insane.
The picture vinyl? I didn't know they did stuff like that.
Yeah. I mean, it cost a lot of money
to do
a vinyl album like that.
Wow.
Crack it. Try to put it in the box set and leave it and hold it. I mean, just look, the bottle fits right in here.
This is what I drank over the weekend for my dad.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Well, but this one is batch 100 that you can only get if you buy the box set. So
oh,
you can't get batch 100 at the store.
I'll crack it and then give me your bottle.
No!
And I'll put that in my box set.
No! Batch 100. Wow, that's cool, Metallica.
All right, let me put this away real quick.
You guys are teases.
Oh, my
Seriously?
God. I don't know. How about when we get some good news?
We'll crack it.
Okay. How about when all the restrictions are lifted? I'll tell you about, we'll crack this when Santa Clarita opens. How about that?
Well, that would be today.
Yeah. What? Santa Clarita opened?
Yeah, Mayor Cameron Smythe. He announced that the public library will be open. Let's see, I lost the tweet here. The dog park, the one and only dog park we have. And the skate park.
The one and only skate park.
The one and only skate park we have will be open.
I don't know if I should open it for that.
I'd wait.
There'd be a lot more stuff to open up in Santa Clarita.
By the way, if you want to get this, because this is amazing, go to blackenedwhiskey.com. Wow. For yourself or for a gift?
Yeah, it has
or just
a seal
a celebration?
On it, batch 100, so I can't really break
That's
that.
That's cool. Yeah. I mean, let's wait till we get some really good news.
Whatever that may be.
I know.
Just hold on to it.
Wow, they really know how to give a gift.
That's good stuff right there.
Amazing.
I get
Between
how
this
about,
and my U.S. Army commendation, I mean, what a Monday.
How about I'll give this away to somebody, to a listener, and you give me yours.
How about we both give them away to a listener? We give them both away.
I think I had a better idea. I give this away to a listener, and then you give me yours.
No.
You want to give both of these away to listeners?
I do.
No. That's just stupid.
I actually think
you were feeling so giving.
I'm like, no, not this time. I give so much all the time. I'm not giving that. This is crazy.
But
good.
I won't do that.
Which I won't.
I really honestly think you guys are safe because I think the FCC doesn't allow you to give away alcohol anyway.
Oh, screw the FCC.
Oh.
No.
The FCC.
Don't screw the FCC. I was hoping they would lighten their rules a little bit. I mean, everybody has. The FDA has. It's trying to get a vaccine out there as fast as possible. The FAA has for, like, people being able to fly drones where you couldn't fly drones before because they don't have employees to go out and check on remote stuff that they can't go look at. So I thought maybe the FCC would lighten a little bit of rules and we can give away sweet liquor and say the F word every now and then. But guess what?
No.
Damn it.
I'll let you know, though.
Yeah, let me know. Get me updated on that.
We'll crack that when we can say the F word.
Yeah, when the FCC lightens their restrictions. So we'll have this for a long time. When batch 200 comes out, we'll crack this. Bad news. Disney's Frozen has become Broadway's first major casualty of the coronavirus pandemic. The production opened in March of 2018, but yesterday the producers announced that it will not return when Broadway reopens. Mm. Whenever that might be. How about we crack this when Broadway reopens?
No. Metallica, because what goes to better together than Metallica and Broadway? Although they could probably do a Broadway show.
Hell yeah, they could.
Mm-hmm.
A new study found that men are less likely than women to wear face masks because they're, quote, not cool and a sign of weakness.
That's what Trump said.
Is that true? Is that why he won't be seen in one?
What do you say,
John? When he goes to a mask factory, you figure it's the mask factory. Put one on.
From what I am told is that he will not wear one because he knows that it will be used against him in this upcoming election.
I don't understand.
That a picture of him wearing a mask will be spread around and they'll say, look what this guy got us into.
But,
and it's not his fault. It's not the reason.
That makes zero sense.
Wouldn't you just be like, listen, I believe that it is also a pandemic and I think
they're more likely to spread around a picture of him with his head superimposed on
Bill Pullman's body
during Independence Day, the shooting of Independence Day.
See, that's inspirational right there. That will get him reelected.
It will?
Yeah.
Oh, come on, Johnny.
He retweeted
his face
that.
On Bill Pullman's head.
They said it happened over the weekend. Day. I missed it. What happened?
No, it's just a video of the
and Bill Pullman's speech. So they had his mouth moving to Bill Pullman's speech.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then people in the crowd are like,
cameos.
Ted Cruz is a photoshopped body, and Ivanka Trump is in there, and
yeah,
somebody did it, and then Trump retweeted it. Look how cool I look.
All right, I'm cracking it.
Cracking it.
There it is. I don't know if anyone's cracked a bottle of this yet, besides the master distillers themselves when they had to come up with Batch 100.
Dave Pickerel.
But, you know, I was like, oh, listen to that. That's one shot. That's so how many gurgles in a shot? One.
Two.
A lot of gurgles in a shot.
Yeah. Was that, wait, are those the big, that's because that's the big shot glass from Malort Challenge.
Yeah, these are the orange juice glasses.
That's a double. Mm-hmm. That's a 2 ounce shot of,
I think normal shots are like 2 3/4 ounces, right?
Oh, are they? I thought they were 1 ounce.
Well, pussy.
Well, yeah, it's a pussy shot, but I'm saying that looks like a big, that's bigger than a normal shot glass, for sure.
No, I think actually it's not. It looks bigger because it's a little plastic disposable, so it doesn't have the thick glass on it.
I don't know, Frank.
But yeah, I think this is a normal shot glass. I think the others you have are like just shots for children. All right. Like when they want to, like, the toy cigarettes. Those
yes.
Are toy
like,
shot
you can
glasses.
Have a shot of apple juice like daddy drinks his whiskey.
All right. You said to drink blackened for your dad who would have been 84 this
yesterday.
Weekend.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'll do a shot of the 100 batch for Dave.
Thank you.
There you go.
Mankind, that word should have new meaning for all of us today.
Mm.
We can't be consumed by our petty differences anymore. We will be united in our common interest. And you will once again be fighting for our freedom. Not from tyranny, oppression, or persecution, but from annihilation. We're fighting for our right to live, to exist. And should we win the day, the 4th of July will no longer be known as an American holiday. But as the day when the world declared in one voice, we will not go quietly into the night, we will not vanish without a fight, we're going to live on. We're going to survive. Today, we celebrate our Independence Day.
That's quite the speech.
Yeah.
Bill pulled off it.
That'll get you riled up,
nice
for sure.
Nice job. America now has its own World War II vet walking for charity. Remember how the UK had the guy?
Oh, yeah. Raised money.
Captain Tom Moore raised millions in the UK last month. Now a 99-year-old in Oregon named Bud Lewis. He's doing it, too. He's raising money for a charity called the Sunshine Division by walking 100 laps around a track before his 100th birthday in August. There he is. For Batch 100.
Seriously,
there
yeah.
There you go, Ben. Oh. Ben Lewis, World War II vet.
Thank you.
And Heidi did mention it briefly when we got this gift from Metallica for Batch 100, which was awesome. This morning at 6 a.m., I did a little presentation here on the air. It was a surprise when we got these today from the Department of the Army Certificate of Appreciation. It says, it's my pleasure and privilege to express my appreciation for your outstanding support during the United States Army Reserve's 245th anniversary. Furthermore, for exemplary conduct in executing reliable and entertaining live and local information during the COVID-19 stay-at-home order. These selfless contributions show great professionalism and patriotism. Your actions reflect great credit upon yourself, 95.5 KLOS, the Southern California broadcast media community, and our United States of America. Mark A. Eisen, Lieutenant Colonel, Army Reserve Deputy Commanding Officer.
That's amazing. Look at that.
Certificate of Appreciation. Look at that.
I think we're in the Army now. I think. First
Army
Brigade.
Army training, sir!
Pacific Division, U.S. Army Reserve Center.
There we go. And a medal that goes with it. The Semper Primo.
First Brigade,
always
Pacific
first.
Division, 84th Trading
That's
Command.
That's pretty awesome.
That is... I don't have anything like this.
That is, yeah, pretty awesome. That's going to go right there in the old office next to my degree from Trump University that I received several years ago for Christmas from Frosty Stillwell. Yeah. So this is awesome. Thank you so much. Sammy was presented with one as well, and Johnny Ice, mm-hmm. Jordan Fitzpatrick, he got his as well. Eric
we
Scott
walked.
Smith,
it was very nice.
Heidi Hamilton, myself. And I don't know if Keith Cunningham is here at work. Did you see him pass by? Keith, if you're listening to the show, if you want to walk in here, we'll turn on the music again, and I will present your certificate from the Army.
Also, we got these really cool, like, what are they, throwing stars?
No, not throwing stars.
I don't know.
It's metal.
It's very heavy.
Yeah.
Semper Primo.
But yeah, the Department of the Army, but I could also appreciate Keith Cunningham, the program director here at KLOS, who's keeping this thing on the air for us and still cranking up the music and trying to find ways to celebrate life as we know it now. So, Keith Cunningham, I'd like
cue
to
the music.
Crank out the music. I'd like to present you with this award, Keith. I don't know if you heard it on the air, but it's from the Department of the Army Certificate of Appreciation awarded to Keith Cunningham.
Oh, thank you so much.
There you go. Swear to God. There it is. And there's your medal. We gotta get our picture. It's like graduation.
You gotta shake hands.
It's like graduation.
I love it.
Get it over here.
Thank you, sir.
There you go.
I appreciate it.
Appreciate you, man.
Thank you, Ten Hut.
Keep doing the Lord's work, my brother.
Woo!
And Keith, I guess I should give you this one as well. This is actually presented to the entire station, 95.5 KLOS. That's actually mine.
He wants the black box.
With a bottle of blackened whiskey in it. Yep. There you go. Presented to 95.5 KLOS, Southern California Rock Station, right there.
Yes, look at that.
So,
we're in the Army now.
There you go. There's your medal as well.
How great is that?
It's here someplace. I'll find it
later. That medal's pretty cool.
First
Brigade, Pacific Division.
Let's toast the Army.
To the Army.
The blackened whiskey. Don't you want to taste this, Heidi? I cracked my bottle.
I do. I'm just, I drank so much yesterday.
Oh, come on. Seriously. This is for the Army.
Just a little bit.
No,
I don't
you're getting a fully.
Frank Kramer.
Seriously, come on. You were just honored.
I know.
By the people who go out and fight for us on a daily basis to make sure that we can do this every single day and the freedoms that we have to do it. So, Heidi, come on. Man up.
I'm going to taste it, but I got to.
Take those panties off.
I'm not wearing panties.
Didn't think you were.
No. Why? Oh, we got
this. Is the song you're playing? Jesus Christ, Harry. So here's to the United States Army Reserve 245th anniversary. Thank you to all who serve.
Thank you. Oh, that's good.
Kill it. Throw her down.
Oh, I will.
No, come on now.
That's a savoring. You don't shoot that kind of whiskey, Frank.
Sipper. Not when you're celebrating the Army.
You
throw it back.
That is delicious.
It'll grow hair on your chest.
Well, see,
maybe it'll remove the hair on yours.
Yep. No,
we'll find out.
No, I see.
After the break.
I see it sprouting.
Let's see another news real quickly before we get the hell out of here. Let's see. We could cut the time it takes to test a vaccine by a few months if 100 people are willing to get the trial version and be infected with the virus. All right, show of hands, who's willing to volunteer to be one of the 100 that would reduce the time by a few months to get a vaccine?
This is for the world, right?
It's for the world.
I feel like I would do that.
You just got a medal from the Army Reserve.
I feel like I would. Let's do it. Let's get it done.
All right, let's infect Heidi, and then we'll move on from there. We'll volunteer Heidi to be part of the 100.
I think we all should. Let's do it.
Eh, not all of us. I mean, at least one of us. Yeah. You see your hand up first.
No.
It's only fair. I'll even give you my medal.
Oh. Okay, I'll take that. I just want it to be over, Frank.
It's a site called One Day Sooner, if you're willing to do this. It's letting people sign up to be part of the 100. And over 20,000 have already applied. So let's do a shot for those 20,000 people who are willing to get the virus so we can get a vaccine.
Well, you know, there are
month earlier.
Those certain people who are called bug chasers. We've talked about them before.
Oh, my God. This is good stuff.
You know, people that want HIV and all kinds of stuff. So they chase
it. Now kill it with me. I'm doing this for everyone who's volunteering.
Do you understand how hungover I am?
Do you understand this is my fifth shot?
I'm hungover?
I never get hungover.
I know. So you don't understand the struggle.
I just can enjoy it.
See?
Forever!
One day you might get hungover.
That's good stuff.
That's good.
Delish.
Double shots.
Woo! Another little feel-good story.
Yesterday, I swore I'd never drink whiskey again. Isn't that funny how things change?
Yep. A 7-year-old in Wisconsin was planning a lemonade stand before this whole shutdown.
Yeah.
So she launched a virtual one with coupons. And it's raising tens of thousands of dollars for charity. Enough to feed over 600 families a week.
Oh, come on.
That's the whole thing about the lemonade stand anyway. It's like, here's some money, kid. I don't really want the lemonade you stirred with your arm.
Right. Your booger
fingers.
Oh,
look at her. There she is.
Oh, she's a little entrepreneur lady.
She's a little nonprofit lady, Heidi.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Not really an entrepreneur. She's not doing this for herself. She's doing
entrepreneurs can
here's
be.
Here's to little kids who want to be in the nonprofit business and go out and helping others. What's her name? I don't even know her name, but here's to you, little 7-year-old from Wisconsin.
What we really should know.
Look
name.
At you.
What's her name?
Oh, look at you doing. Look at that. That's what America's going to be in the future, right there.
That's right.
Little fat kids.
Stop it. Oh, my God. She's got her little baby fat, her little chubby cheeks.
She's a little beyond baby at 7 years old.
I'm going to get my kid to make copies of those right there. So she will, the counterfeit lemonade.
Superimpose your Trump's face on her.
Yeah. Does look a little like Eric Trump.
There's another feel-good story. A guy in Belgium who has access to a crane. He's been taking it to nursing homes so people can visit family members at their windows on high floors. He was driving by a home recently, saw a guy yelling up to his mom from the sidewalk, and he realized he could help. Come Here's on. To you, crane guy.
Oh, no, you're not.
Look at you, just seeing some guy yelling up to his mom, and you know what? I got a cherry picker.
Oh, that, come on. It really is so heartwarming.
There's really no point in yelling up to her when I can help you out like that.
What?
No, I said I miss you, and I wish I could hug you.
Here's to cranes.
Cranes. Bob Crane. Cranes, the bird. Let's name all the cranes we know.
Oh, that's it.
Crane.
Someone made a site called isolationcreations.org to celebrate all the creative stuff people have done in lockdown, like music and art projects.
Oh, yeah.
So here's to you, independent music and art project people.
You are not.
Still pursuing your dreams, even though nobody can come see it.
Well, we've on
yeah, that bottle's half gone.
On New Music Friday, you did, last week, you did have a lot of songs called Quarantine and
Yeah, it makes people creative.
Yeah.
I mean, either you're the type to just shut down completely, or you're the type where you have to make something, you have to do something. So there's a lot of people out there that are just putting stuff together
because they
have to.
And graduates, don't forget that Krispy Kreme's giving away free donuts this week.
Oh, do you have
so
to
you
wear your
captain gown in? Yeah, or maybe something that says class of 2020 on it. And you get a dozen free donuts. So there's Krispy Kreme and all you graduates out there.
We're getting kicked out of the army today, I'm pretty sure.
For one last little shot there for you graduates and Krispy Kreme donuts. Couldn't do it without you. Seriously, that's quite a dent.
That's, yeah, we're down to the,
In what, the last 19 minutes?
Yep.
We could probably kill it before it's over.
We?
Don't challenge me.
I meant
Christ.
Show. I meant
you
show.
You still got one shot
meant,
to kill.
I meant show everybody. Everybody on the show.
Jesus Christ.
All right.
You got some news?
I do. A Norco Pancake House joined a handful of other
Here's
local...
Here's to the news.
A Norco Pancake House joined a handful of other local businesses in reopening Sunday in defiance of state orders meant to curb the spread of corona. Patrons lined up outside the original Pancake House in Norco early Sunday morning. Even before it opened its doors, people were eager for a breakfast at a restaurant.
Oh, I haven't toasted pancakes in a long time.
Oh, God. One woman, Norco resident Mary Weller, said, I'm pregnant and I'm not afraid. I think it's time. I understood the lockdown in the beginning and now I'm like, it's time. We can't kill local businesses. Well, the restaurant staff wore face masks as they maneuvered between the tables at the busy restaurant, some of which were kept empty to allow for social distancing. And though the restaurant said it's taking precautions and following guidelines posted by the Centers for Disease Control, it drew outrage online for those from those who concerned about the spread of the virus, with many calling the move irresponsible and illegal. The Pancake House is one of several businesses in the county to reopen despite state orders, including a hair salon in Corona and a bar in Riverside. Health experts and officials have warned that reopening too much too soon, especially without safety restrictions, would risk a spike in infections and force more closures. And speaking of reopening, auto plants in Michigan, restaurants in Maine, malls in Minnesota, gyms in South Carolina. Well, today is a big day for reopening in America. State and localities are easing stay-at-home restrictions across the country, but encouraging social distancing and face masks by residents. Meanwhile, the number of Americans who say they're social distancing has dropped since late March. According to a Gallup poll released last week, the drop isn't just from individuals who live in states where they can now dine in restaurants, get haircuts in barbershops, or visit parks, but most people and more people in the states that still have stay-at-home restrictions are no longer social distancing. They're over it. And this is a very sad story. Lifeguards rescued a 10-year-old boy at Venice Beach while an ongoing underwater search for a man believed to be his father was suspended yesterday evening. L.A. County Fire Department crews were called to the beach along the 4200 block of Oceanfront Walk. This was shortly before 4 p.m. to help L.A. County lifeguards with reports of two missing swimmers. They had swam out to rescue a group of swimmers caught in strong riptide currents. The group was pulled out by the rip current. A child was found. Evaluated, he did not require hospitalization, but Barnes, This LAFD spokesperson said lifeguards were unable to save another one of the swimmers struggling in the currents who was submerged underwater. From the lifeguards, lifeguards upgraded their rescue efforts to a full dive response. The U.S. Coast Guard assisted in the search for the man who was believed to be in his 30s. Crews searched underwater while an L.A. County Fire Department chopper flew overhead. LFD paramedics remained on standby, but shortly after 8 p.m. last night, LAFD said underwater search efforts were called off for the night, saying it's ineffective. It's not very safe to dive during nighttime hours. The department said lifeguards will continue land-based patrols. I guess they started that back up this morning, diving efforts at 7 a.m. this morning. And more bad news. Police and fire investigators launched a criminal probe yesterday into the cause of an explosion at a hash oil manufacturer in downtown L.A. that sent firefighters running for their lives. Detectives from the L.A. Police Department's Major Crimes Division were working with the city's fire department arson investigators to determine what might have sparked the blast that shot a ball of flames out of a building Saturday night and scorched a fire truck across the street. The blast injured a dozen firefighters, some of them who ran out on sidewalks where they tore off their burning protective equipment, including melted helmets. Firefighters first thought they were battling a routine structure fire, but as they got a little further into the building, they started to hear a loud hissing sound and a significant rumbling that you could feel vibrating throughout the entire area. He said one significant explosion shook the neighborhood around 6:30 p.m. Firefighters inside had to run through a wall of flames that he estimated were 30 feet high and 30 feet wide. And those on the roof scrambled down a ladder that they were engulfed in flames. Three firefighters were released after spending the night in the hospital. Fire Department spokesman Nicholas Prange said on Sunday, of the eight who remain hospitalized, two were in critical but stable condition. And a spokesman for the LAFD later told KTLA two firefighters who were on ventilators were taken off the devices. They continue to remain in intensive care. And also, the building was a warehouse for a place called Smoketokes, which he described as a supplier for makers of butane honey oil. And butane is an odorless gas that easily ignites and is used in the process to extract the high-inducing chemical THC from cannabis to create a highly potent concentrate, also known as hash oil. The oil is then used in vape pens, edibles, waxes, and other products. And there was a death in Hollywood, somebody we all know and love, legendary comic actor Fred Willard. He died on Friday of natural causes. He was 86 years old. His daughter Hope said he passed away, quote, very peacefully. You know him. If you don't know his name, you know his face for sure. Fred was in a ton of stuff. He was best known for his improv skills, like in the Christopher Guest mockumentaries Waiting for Guffman, Best in Show, A Mighty Wind, For Your Consideration, and Mascots. He was also in This is Spinal Tap, which was directed by Rob Reiner. And Fred was the station manager in Anchorman movies. So now you know him, don't you? And the CEO of the By and Large Corporation of WALL-E, the only live-action character in that movie. On TV, he had a recurring role as Hank McDougal on the later seasons of Everybody Loves Raymond, and he played Phil's dad on several episodes of Modern Family. He's also in the upcoming Netflix show Space Force. And back in the day, Fred was on Fernwood Tonight, which was a spinoff of Mary Hartman, and you could regularly see him showing up on skits on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno. And just a few days before Fred's death, he was mourning the loss of his pal Jerry Stiller on Twitter. He said, quote, I met him in the 60s when we played in the same clubs as he and Ann Mira. Unfortunately for us, they were much funnier. We couldn't be jealous, so we just became good friends instead. So RIP Fred Willard, you will be missed, and that's your news.
He's got this Department of Army Certificate of Appreciation, and I thought these were medals that we were given, but I'm being told from the 484, those are not medals. They are coins to be given. One of those is known as being coined. So they're coins, not medals. Mm. Also, that's a special gesture that usually comes from higher-ranked service personnel.
Wow.
So 949 says, what are you drinking? It's a blackened whiskey, the Batch 100. You want to pick up this special box set? You can only get the Batch 100 if you buy the box set at blackandwhiskey.com. And somebody else says, do a cheers for us essential workers, Frank. Oh my God, all right. Let me do one more shot for the essential workers. I'm starting to feel it in the frontal lobe, folks. I've had a lot of black and whiskey in the last 20 minutes. I mean, seriously, I almost killed half this bottle.
Frontal lobe. That's so funny.
It's happening. All right, so here's to all the essential workers out there. I'll raise my glass. You better kill it for essential workers.
You relax.
Jesus Christ. Seriously.
You celebrate how you celebrate.
Drinks on this show.
Well.
Drink all weekend long. You can't drink on the program for essential workers. Jesus Christ. Just got coined by the Army. You can't take a full shot.
Yeah. I'm a real pussy. I should just be in the Navy.
Well, you are what you eat. All right. Let's apologize to those we have offended today and get the hell out of here.
Oh, God.
Mm. Raspberry farmers, chatting monks, female pilots, and transgendered babies.
White trash, pregnant women, Airbnb, and Ming and Ling.
Violinist, silly walkers, time-traveling Nazis, and strippers.
My Uncle Pee-wee, bullfighters, women with what?
Oh, dear.
Hirsutism. Hirsutism.
Oh, the hairy women.
The old giant beaver chicks.
Yeah, yeah.
And Bob Ross.
Kissing cousins.
I don't know how they're related.
Park. Bug chasers. And the U.S. Army. So sorry.
Canadians. Fishermen. Bill Pullman. And Black and Whiskey. Here's to you, Black and Whiskey. Do one more shot for Black and Whiskey.
Oh, my God.
Get your box set. Blaskinwiki.com.
Watch Dish Nation.
Yeah, watch Dish Nation tonight. Like I said, it's hitting all the lobes now.
It's when you're at your best.
In the hypothalamus as well.
That's what keeps your engine running, Frank.
It's going to be a hell of a show. We're frosty out of here, Frank.
Oh.
95.5 KLOS and KLOS HD1 Los Angeles.
Streaming online at 95.5KLOS.com.
This is Southern California's rock station. 95.5 KLOS.